Coming up on Blazer Action News.
COVID cases skyrocketing in the Sun City.
We'll take a closer look.
What's up with the weather lately? We'll take you there.
Today is November 6th.
And Blazer Action News starts now.
Good morning, Blazer Nation, and welcome to another installment of Blazer Action News.
And I'm Melody Agüero. I hope everyone had a spectacular Halloween.
If you haven't seen the news, El Paso is making national headlines.
Eyeballs across the nation, all on us.
Here's Fabian Edizel with the story.
Hospitals in El Paso are currently overflowing due to the sudden boom in COVID-19 cases. This week, nearly 1,000 people were hospitalized, with 300 in the intensive care. The El Paso Convention and Performing Arts Center has been turned into a makeshift hospital to help with the surge.
But if today you're in a car accident and you go to the hospital, you will be under that same constraints of not having the appropriate space and in the care that you would have in any other situation.
Reports indicate that since October 22nd, roughly 1,000 people per day test positive with no sign of slowing down. El Paso has reached more than 20,000 active COVID-19 cases, with 4,500 of them being teenagers. The rising cases has prompted local leaders to take action. El Paso County Judge Ricardo Samaniego called for a lockdown, which would limit travel and shut down non-essential services like in-person dining, gyms, and salons. However, Texas Governor Greg Abbott has stepped in an effort to halt the lockdown. Now more than ever, we need you to help in stopping the spread of this pandemic by remaining socially distant as possible. Stay home if it is not a necessity, and of course washing your hands as much as possible. If you are sick and you don't want to risk going to the hospitals, here are some tips on how to treat yourself at home. Take any cold medications that will help with the symptoms. Boil water, then put a towel over your head and stand over the pot, which will clear your sinuses. Stay hydrated and have shows to watch for the next 2 weeks. Reporting for Blazer Action News, I am Fabian Vasquez.
No matter what happens, we have to remember to stay safe and stay El Paso strong.
One way to stay safe is to wear our masks.
You've heard it before. I'd be lying if I didn't say that masks are uncomfortable.
I feel you, Efra. Let's check this week's Obeyes on how masks can impact our lives.
I should like to help everyone if possible. Jew, Gentile, black man, white. We all want to help one another. Human beings are like that. We want to live by each other's happiness, not by each other's misery.
Let's not forget to wear a mask when we go out.
We understand that these times are hard. Always trust to talk to your counselor.
Let's take a quick break. We'll be right back.
day.
In 1992, Lagos, Nigeria established a special anti-robbery squad, better known as SARS, to combat crimes associated with robbery, motor vehicle theft, kidnapping, cattle rustling, and firearms. 10 years later, in 2002, SARS made its way to all 36 states of federation. Over the past 3 years, 82 cases have been recorded of SARS violent behavior towards citizens, beatings, hangings, mock executions, sexual assaults, and waterboarding, targeting young people to extort their belongings. The presidential committees offer guidance to improve the Nigeria police. Nigerian President Goodluck Jonathan funds $196 million for police reforms, yet no real change is seen, and SARS continues to abuse power. A lot of money to be wasted for not much improvement. The promises by Nigerian government to reform SARS units have led to no difference. Due to the continued recorded violations committed by SARS, no SARS officer has been held accountable for their criminal behavior. The Inspector General of Nigerian Police Force announced the process to reduce SARS units' excessive force. Once again, the improvement failed. March 2017. SARS arrested Miracle and detained him in Anambra State to be charged with theft. Miracle spent 40 days of poor treatment in detention before being taken to court, only for the court to dismiss the case from lack of evidence. Later on in the year, Nigerian citizens launched a media campaign to document the horrendous acts and demand an overhaul of the SARS unit. #EndSARS. Nigeria's vice president ordered the overhaul of SARS, but the abuse from SARS agents towards citizens still continued throughout the year. A long list of broken promises. October 11th, SARS fired shots towards university student Jamal Isaac during a peaceful protest. October 12th, police officers killed 55-year-old Ike Chukwu during another peaceful protest and began to arrest many protesters. October 20th, a peaceful protest in Lekki toll gate. A blackout from the streetlights occurred, and officers and soldiers started to open fire, injuring over 100 citizens and killing 12.
Know what they're doing on the road. They're not on the road to solve any crimes. They're on the road to take money from people. They're on the road to find who their next victim is going to be.
Welcome back, Blazers.
The season is changing.
And with that comes a lot of bipolar weather.
Make sure you have a blanket and a tank top when you go out.
We never know if we might have a hailstorm or a drought.
Let's see what last week's snow day was all about.
Blazers, winter's right around the corner, so be sure to have those tiger and lion blankets ready. I know everyone has one. Alongside that, have some hoodies, sweatshirts, and sweatpants to stay warm and comfortable throughout the day. El Paso is known for its unpredictable weather conditions because one day can go from looking and feeling like this to this at a moment's notice. You just never know with El Paso's weather. It may be cold in the mornings and then super hot in the afternoon. So it's nice to have some shorts and some t-shirts in case the weather does a complete 180.
Abnormal weather isn't the only thing we need to worry about.
COVID is affecting everything around us.
Sports have been unfortunately canceled.
We don't have any scores for you, but we do have some thoughts from some Blazer athletes.
Led me to find other ways to work out and stay in shape rather than doing what I love most, and that is swimming. I wish people be more realistic. Even though places are opening back up, the virus is not over. People should still take precautions necessary, wearing a mask, washing your hands, not only to protect yourself, but to protect others, and especially those close to us.
Because of the pandemic, we haven't really had practice at all, which made it a lot more difficult for us to actually start working out and get that endurance back. I would hope that people practice social distancing and wear masks whenever they go out. That way, we could prevent anybody else from getting sick, so that hopefully my team could get a season this year, and so all this whole pandemic can be over soon.
In sports, I'm not really getting the motivation to work out and get in shape as I used to for in swimming, but I really wish people would follow the guidelines correctly. But I know some people, one of the rules is to wear masks, and some people wear them, but they wear them incorrectly. Under the nose when it's supposed to be over the nose, and practice social distancing. And just for everybody else, continue practicing, whether you're in band or basketball, just continue trying your best.
That's all we've got for this week, Blazers.
Remember to stay safe, stay distanced, and don't wear a mask when you wash your teeth, please.
This has been
Blazer Action News.
Blazers, follow us on Twitter at AmericasBAN for sneak peeks and updates, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Hey Blazers, would you like to be part of Blazer Action News? Share your story on how you've been affected by COVID-19. We want to hear from you. Send us your 1-minute video to watchblazeractionnews@gmail.com and see if your video makes it on the show.